Biology.
Yes, hello there and welcome again to today's class, where in this class we are going to learn on how to test for starch from a green leaf. Now here I've drawn a diagram to represent the whole process for the testing of starch in a green leaf, where we are going to get our green leaf and test for starch until we have a confirmation that our leaf had starch or not. So how are we going to begin in this test for starch from a green leaf? So the first step, you must get a leaf from the field that had been exposed to sunlight for 2 to 3 hours. At least that leaf would have photosynthesized enough. So we have our green leaf over there. So on to the next step. What are we going to do to the next step? So after getting this green leaf from the field, so the next step, you should put the leaf in a boiling water. So like the experiment demonstrates, so you should put the leaf in boiling water. So what is the reason why you should put the leaf in boiling water? So the reason is that the leaf should be put in boiling water so as to rupture all the starch that were present in the leaf. Also, the leaf should be put in boiling water so as to kill any tissues that were present in the leaf. So after doing this for about 10 to 5 minutes, so the next step, what will you do in the next step? So in the next step, you will extract the leaf from the beaker that had the boiling water, and then put the leaf inside another boiling tube or a beaker inside a water bath that contained methylated spirit. I'll repeat. So after extracting the leaf from the boiling water, so the next step, you should take a boiling tube that contains methylated spirit and then put that boiling tube containing methylated spirit on a hot water bath. For after some time, after the methylated spirit has become somewhat warm, you should take your leaf and place it inside or submerge it inside the hot water bath. So why is this process necessary? So this process is necessary because the methylated spirit discolorizes the leaf. So it discolorizes the leaf from green color to white or brown color. That's the function of the methylated spirit. So you should note that after you have taken your leaf into the methylated spirit, when you extract the leaf will be very stiff. So why is this? So the leaf will be very stiff because the methylated spirit will have extracted all the water that were present in the leaf. So after you have extracted the leaf that was in the boiling tube containing the methylated spirit, what are you going to do next? So after that, you should take your leaf and place it on a white tile. So in the white tile, be sure to take very good care or be very gentle with your leaf because it is very brittle. It can break anytime. So in this step, you will add some drops of water to the leaf. Why do we add drops of water to the leaf? So the reason why we add some droplets of water to the leaf is to rehydrate the leaf. Because remember, methylated spirit had dehydrated or it had removed all the water present in the leaf. Now, the main reason why we are adding water in this case, it's because we are trying to rehydrate the leaf. You should take caution not to add too much water in the leaf, as this might lead to a negative test for our starch. So what you should do, you should only add a few drops or a little amount of water to the leaf, at least to rehydrate it. So the last step, how will you determine that starch is present in our leaf? So we'll take the leaf from the white tile and place it on a new white tile. And in this process, we are going to take another clean dropper, get iodine, and then pour 2 to 3 drops of iodine on the leaf. Then wait to see what will happen. The regions that will be having starch, the iodine color will change from brown to blue-black. The regions that won't be having starch, the iodine color will still remain brown in color. And now for this experiment, since some regions of the leaf will have a blue-black color of the iodine changing from brown to blue-black, thereby will have proved that indeed starch was present in the leaf. So if the leaf completely didn't have any blue-black color, this means that the leaf didn't photosynthesize at all. But that is very rare, because once a leaf has enough water and it is on clear sunlight, so it must photosynthesize. So thank you again for today. Thank you for this lesson, and I hope to see you on the next class. Biology.